I'm the queen of obsession. Everybody knows my name. You're popular now, but you don't have half my fame. Yuki, Yuki, let me take this girl out. She wants to try to take my throne like she knows what it's about. Ayano, Gacha, my future diary states, I'll end you faster than an axe to your face.
You weren't the first, Andre. You just made it a trend that every queen's greedy reign must come to an end. Don't act like you're perfect. You made a million mistakes. Trying to count all your failures would give me a headache. You caught your man, drugged him, and tied him down in some place. But he managed to escape and even slapped you in the face. What kind of a yandere would let her man go free? And do I even need to mention the thing with Tsubaki?
At least I got to go on a date with him, unlike you. You get so nervous around Taro, you don't even know what to do. Except squirm around as if your IQ dropped to 5. Taro's better off without you, dead or alive.
It doesn't make a difference if you're fine around Yuki. I'm still more stable than you. And my parents still love me. Or do I have to throw you back in that little cage you hate? I'll lock the door, melt the key, and let the rat seal your fate.
I got Yuki in the end and became a god, remember? A yandere never stops, gives up, or surrenders. But when your senpai sees you slice a girl's throat open, you fall to your knees and end up heartbroken.
When the screen fades to black, that doesn't mean that's a wrap. Because you seem to have forgotten that I have the choice to snap. You may have grown to be a yandere, but I was born broken. Now let's see whose name you scream when I rip your chest open.